game. I just wanna shine and I gotta let it show. Show up on the scene, walk right through the door. Got it on repeat, it's my double up flow. Vibrate the whole building, name ringing through your phone. Waiting till the smoke clear, can you see me through the fog? Fall back, it could go all bad. We be going hard with your exotic. What's going on, guys? Welcome to another installment of Daily MLB Recaps. And I think this is episode 34, if I'm not mistaken. And we had a very special performance from Lucas Giolito. We'll talk about that game when we get there. But first game, we have game one of a doubleheader between the Astros and Angels. This game went to the Astros. Rookie Christian Javier had another strong outing. I would say he'd be challenging Luis Robert for Rookie of the Year, but he had one really, really bad start. But Astros win that one 6-3. Marlins shut out the Mets 4-0 in game one of a doubleheader. Fantastic pitching performance from their entire team. They had sort of a smorgasbord of players. Daniel Castellano, Brad Boxberger, Brandon Kinsler has been really strong for the Marlins. He's closed it out in big situations. Luis Brinson, Miguel Rojas, and they all pushed across runs. Nice little single approach in the first inning, and they win 4-0. Phillies defeat the Nationals 8-3. Real Muto hit a three-run homer in the first inning, kind of give them a strong footing. Jake Arrieta had a really strong start, and they coast to a win over the Nationals. They're 11-14, Nationals 11-16. Red Sox defeat the Blue Jays 9-7. Rafael Devers hit a three-run triple in the winning effort. Red Sox are now 10-20. Blue Jays pitching really did not show up in this game. Craig Anderson gave up three earned runs in five innings. The Rays defeat the Orioles 4-2. They're now the third, I think, team to join the 20-win club. Tyler Glasnow records 13 strikeouts, a career high for him, and they defeat the Orioles 4-2. Orioles are 14-15. They're like right on the edge of the playoff picture. The Angels defeat the Astros 12-5 in game two of the doubleheader. Felix Pena had a really strong start, and the offense just completely exploded. Nothing really much else to say about that game. Angels are 10-22. Astros are 17-14. The Indians defeat the Twins 4-2. These are important divisional games for the Indians. They want to pass the Twins for the divisional lead. Shane Bieber with another 10. I think every single start he's had 10 strikeouts. Another 10 strikeout performance. 6 innings, 2 earned runs, 10 strikeouts. This game was 2-1 Twins in the 6th, but Francisco Lindor hit a 2-run shot to take the lead. And then Tyler Naquin hit a double that scored Carlos Santana. Bullpen shut it down for the Indians, and they get the win. I believe there are 2 games behind the Twins, if I'm not mistaken. Let me check the records. They're 2.5 behind. The Cubs get murdered by the Tigers 7-1. This game was very sad. Jonathan Scope and Spencer Turnbull was terrific on the mound. Tyler Chatwood got lit up. Tyler Chatwood has either been so off or on this year, and it's been more off as of late. Jonathan Scope hit a grand slam in a 5-run 6th inning, and then the Cubs lose. I don't know what else you want me to say. The A's defeat the Rangers 10-3. They are now 21-10. Olsen and Semien both went deep. Sean Manaea has, in his last 3 starts, has only given up 3 runs. So he's been pitching very, very well. Now to your performance of the day. The 19th no-hitter in White Sox history belongs to Lucas Giolito. He no-hits the worst team in baseball, the Pittsburgh Pirates. I'm not trying to take anything away from him, but absolutely. And this wasn't this was a dominant no-hitter. 13 strikeouts. He only allowed 1 base runner, and it was a walk. If he didn't walk, I think it was Josh Bell. I think he walked Polanco. If he didn't walk Polanco, he would have had a perfect game. Just absolutely all-around fantastic performance from Lucas Giolito. That was just dominant to watch. Dominant to watch. Absolutely wonderful stuff. He's your player. That's your the leaning catch by Adam Engel at the end of the game. That's your player of the day. Lucas Giolito is your player of the day. The Brewers win a close, tight, competitive game against the underperforming Reds, 3-2. Reds were 11-17, really thought that they'd be better. They jumped up to a 2-0 lead in the fourth inning off of a Mike Moustakas single. But in that same fourth inning, the Brewers battled back with a Ben Gamel double and an Orlando Arcia single. And they claw back. They win 3-2. Strong pitching performance from them. The Royals defeat the Cardinals 5-4. Ryan McBroom had a very strong effort. He hit a go-ahead single in the eighth inning. It was tied 4-4 in the sixth after Ryan O'Hearn tied it up with a solo shot. Then Ryan McBroom with a single to shallow left scored the run. And the Royals win this one 5-4. Next we have the Mariners defeating the Padres 8-3. Kind of a setback for the Padres after they'd been playing fantastically well. J.P. Crawford went deep. Austin Nola went deep. All the Padres could muster off were homers from Hosmer and France. But the Mariners, they had their way with Chris Paddock. Chris Paddock did not have a great start. Five innings pitched, six earned runs. And the Mariners get a win there. Next, we have the Rockies defeating the Diamondbacks 5-4. God, dude. The Diamondbacks were playing so well, and I was getting so cocky about when they find their stride, they're a dangerous team, and now they're losing again. It was 2-2 after the second inning, then it was 3-3 after the fourth. Really back-and-forth game. In the seventh, Arenado had a double to left, and Arenado scored on a passed ball by Carson Kelly. And then they rallied back, and then the Diamondbacks couldn't come back. David Bard shuts down a save. So Rockies get the win there. Marlins win game two of their doubleheader against the Mets. They win 3-0, 14 innings of shutout baseball from the Marlins pitching staff. Fantastic stuff from them. Brian Anderson doubled the shallow left of the fourth inning. And then check this out. John Birdie steals home in the bottom of the sixth inning. You almost never see that. I'm changing that. That's your play of the day. Giolito's your player of the day. So John Birdie actually stole first, second, and third in this inning. But this is just a lazy catcher. I think that's Tomas Nito. But John Birdie just takes advantage of a completely lazy catcher. As soon as he throws that back, you're going. You think you have enough time, and he did barely though. I mean, if he didn't stumble, he's in there way safely. But that is just taking advantage of a lazy catcher. I've done that before, and fantastic stuff by John Birdie. Way to bring speed and fun back into baseball. That is just so risky to steal home, but it's fantastic when it works out. He almost fell down. He was like, he was stumbling, but he got it done. Gotta love that from John Birdie. The Marlins have a ton of speed on their team. Man, Gurney, Sierra, Lewis, Brinson, John Birdie, they're all guys with like 90-plus speed in MLB The Show. And lastly, the Giants walk off on the Dodgers 10-8. And this was a game that kind of got away from LA. They had the homers working in the first. They had Muncy, Seager, Jock Peterson, big RBI doubles. It's 6-3 in the third. The Giants rallied back to tie it, to make it 6-5. And then this Brandon Belt homer ties the game in the ninth inning. And so we go to extra innings. In the top of the tenth, Justin Turner scored on an error by Joey Bart. But then Marciano Dubon got an infield single in the 10th, so we go to the 11th. In the 11th, Justin Turner reaches on another infield single, but then Evan Longoria singles to score Yastrzemski. And then in the bottom of the 11th, Donovan Solano, with this home run, wins the game for the Giants. They're actually creeping into the playoff picture. They're 15-16. They're a team that I think if they get hot, you should watch out for them. Dodgers are 22-9. They're going to... I saw the teams at the highest playoff probability were the Dodgers at 99.9%, the Cubs at 97.8%. But the Giants win, and a much-needed win for them. If they want to make the playoffs, they really needed to win that game. So I hope you guys enjoy. Yankees-Braves was postponed due to rainy weather. I was excited for that game. But anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I'll see you next time.